The Philippine police will enforce maximum deployment to keep the streets safe. That remark comes after Vice President Sara Duterte met with security officials to tackle peace and order. The PNP says members of the Special Action Force will also be tapped to help augment police presence.
Malinaw po yung directives po ng ating Vice President bilang siya pong itinalagang OIC in the absence po ng ating Pangulo, na mas lalong palakasin po at siguraduhin magiging ligtas po yung ating mga mamamayan sa araw-araw nilang pamumuhay. Kaya ang instruction po ay maximum deployment po tayo.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa, meanwhile, expresses concern over various reports of kidnapping across the country.
I am very much alarmed, being the chairman of public order and dangerous drugs. I am very much alarmed. So dapat kikilos ang PNP dito ng mabilis para maaksyonan at makakita ng results. Otherwise, itong mga tao na ito, feeling ko sila forgive me for my conclusion. Feeling invincible again sila with the exit of President Duterte from Malacañang.
The Public Works and Highways Department gives more details on the Marcos administration's infrastructure program. ABS-CBN correspondent Wena Cos now joins us for an update. Wena?
Yes, Denise, Chief Implementer of Flagship Programs and Projects and DPWH Undersecretary Emil Sadain presented to the Committee on Flagship Programs and Projects of the Lower House on Wednesday 44 infrastructure projects in continuance of the previous administration's Build, Build, Build program. Of the 44, 31 are under the Unified Project Management Office, including the program to support the rehabilitation and reconstruction of Marawi City and surrounding areas, flood risk management projects, and integrated disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation measures in Pampanga Bay. There are 7 regional operations, including coastal, economic, and high-speed roads. 4 of the 44 infrastructure projects are expressways under the Public-Private Partnership Program, while 2 are under mixed financing. Meanwhile, there are 10 pipeline projects, 6 of which are roads, 1 for flood control, and the 3 remaining are bridges. According to the DPWH, the infrastructure programs target 4 areas: traffic decongestion, creating an integrated transport system, converging rural road development, and creating livable, sustainable, and resilient communities. The Committee on Flagship Programs and Projects will meet again with the different government agencies involved in infrastructure projects for completion for the remaining 3 months of the year and for projects in 2023 and onwards. Denise?
Thanks, Wena. The Commission on Higher Education halts its cash loan program for students. Let's get more details from ABS-CBN's Robert Mano. Robert?
The Commission on Higher Education stopped implementing its program, Study Now, Pay Later, which seeks to assist college students through loans which will be paid after the graduation. During the Senate Committee on Higher Technical and Vocational Education hearing Wednesday morning, Chairperson Prospero De Vero said they opted to terminate the program because of extremely low payment rate, which was less than 10% of the total loans. It is because most of those who availed were not able to get jobs after graduation, therefore could not make enough money to pay off their loans. To replace the program, the CHED allotted 1 billion pesos under the Unified Student Financial Assistance System for tertiary education, or UNIFAS. This is similar to the University of the Philippines Loan Program, where the students can borrow, and if they pay it within the school year, there will be no interest. If not, they will have to pay it before they graduate. Denise.
Thanks, Robert.